These GLP-1 patches have been flooding my feed lately.
Everywhere I scroll, there's some ad claiming that you can just slap on a sticker and lose weight without a prescription or an injection.
At first glance, it sounds like a dream. A needle-free version of Ozempic? Who wouldn't want that? And it's available over the counter. But here's the thing. The claims don't add up. And the more I looked into it, the more red flags I found.
They're saying these patches are a scam, and honestly, I believe them until I tried it. I've been on them for 2 weeks. I put them on a thin part of my skin just so it can absorb. And here are the side effects that no one's telling you about. I didn't experience any nausea. I didn't get jittery. My food noise, shoo. And y'all, it's like my brain finally stopped negotiating with the fridge.
But all that said, is there something to them? Could they work? We're going to break it all down in today's video. I'm going to be talking about what exactly these patches are, what exactly GLP-1 is, and what the science actually says. I'm Kait, a nutritionist who has helped hundreds of clients reverse insulin resistance and lose weight naturally. I cut through the noise so you can make confident, informed choices about your health. It's not as complicated as a lot of people make it out to be. All right, so let's start with the basics. What exactly are GLP-1 patches? Because if you've seen these ads, you know. They make it sound like it's the next big thing in weight loss. The pitch is simple. It's a little patch, kind of like a nicotine patch, that you stick on your arm, stomach, or thigh. From there, it supposedly releases ingredients that mimic GLP-1, the same hormone that drugs like Ozempic, Wegovy, and Mounjaro are based on. Now, this patch is making a lot of claims. It claims it can suppress your appetite, increase fat burning, stabilize your blood sugar, tighten your skin, improve digestion, and even help you lose up to 6 pounds in just 1 week. No needle, no prescription, and no side effects. Just peel, stick, and let it do its thing. And I get it. This idea is super appealing. We've all seen the results that things like Ozempic are getting people. But the fact that it has to be injected has a lot of people hesitant. Now, this is not me advocating for Ozempic, Mounjaro, or any of those. Yes, they do have a place for the right person, but there are definitely pros and cons. But I do see the appeal here. Some people don't qualify for prescription medications like Ozempic, or they can't afford them. So when you see something that claims to offer all the same benefits, it's tempting to try. Now, I've really only seen these ads on TikTok, and let me tell you, they're pretty flashy, they're pretty catchy. They definitely made me stop scrolling. They use a lot of phrases like FDA certified, clinically proven, or doctor recommended, even though these claims don't actually mean what a lot of people think. FDA certified doesn't actually mean that it's FDA approved, and especially for a drug claim like this. But with that being said, the idea behind it, mimicking GLP-1, does carry some merit. And that's why so many people fall for this. The issue is how they're going about it, and that's what we're going to dig into next. So let's talk about GLP-1 and how it actually works, because it's a hormone. So let's talk about the hormone GLP-1 and how it actually works. And this part matters because if you don't understand how GLP-1 works, the whole patch situation won't make sense. So stick with me here. GLP-1 stands for glucagon-like peptide 1. It's a hormone your body naturally releases after you eat, and its job is to regulate your blood sugar and your appetite. Now, it does this in a few different ways. It tells your pancreas to release insulin when glucose is present. It slows gastric emptying, so food stays in your stomach for longer and you feel full faster. And it signals your brain that you're satisfied and don't need more food. It basically turns down the volume on your hunger. And this is exactly why GLP-1 based medications like Ozempic and Wegovy have become so popular. They amplify the natural GLP-1 response to help control cravings and improve blood sugar regulation. And that's why they're so effective for type 2 diabetes, insulin resistance, and even weight loss. But here's the catch. GLP-1 is a peptide. This means it's a chain of amino acids, and peptides are fragile. Your body breaks them down quickly if they're not delivered properly. And that's why these drugs come in the form of injections. Because if you took GLP-1 by mouth or tried to rub it into your skin, your body would just destroy it before it ever had the chance to work. So let's be real. If GLP-1 medications could work through a patch, don't you think pharmaceutical companies would be all over this by now? The reason you don't see a prescription GLP-1 patch at your pharmacy is because it doesn't work. Peptides like GLP-1 are too large and unstable to be absorbed through the skin. Patches like this only work for certain kinds of compounds, small molecules like nicotine or estrogen. These can actually penetrate the skin barrier and enter your bloodstream in a controlled way. GLP-1 is a whole different beast. It breaks down quickly in the digestive tract, and it doesn't pass through the skin. That's why even the real medications have to be injected under the skin, to bypass digestion and get directly into your system. So when this company claims that their patch is releasing GLP-1 into the bloodstream, this is a massive red flag, especially when they don't have any clinical trials or even an ingredients list to back it up. And now let's get into the sales tactics, because this is where things get really shady. If you look at these ads, they use classic tricks, buzzwords like FDA certified, which usually just means the manufacturer's registered, not that the product is approved. Doctor recommended, but no doctor is actually named. Clinically proven, with zero links to studies. Before and after photos that look suspiciously edited. And my personal favorite, lose 6 pounds in 7 days, effortlessly. These kind of claims should make anyone pause. And here's the thing, even if they're not harmful, there's no evidence they're helpful either. They're using fear-based and hope-based marketing to target people who are frustrated, overwhelmed, and just want something that works. And I totally understand that. But this isn't it. Okay, so now that I've broken down why this is a no-go, why you shouldn't waste your money here, let's get into what you can do that actually works. And these tips are probably things that you've never heard before. Like I said, I'm not just gonna tell you to eat less. I'm not just gonna tell you to exercise more. There's more to it than that. If you wanna lose weight, improve your insulin sensitivity, and lower your blood sugar. The reason that a lot of people are overweight is because they have undiagnosed insulin resistance. And you can be insulin resistant even if your blood sugar looks normal. I've spoken about that in many videos, so I won't get too much into it today. I'll link another video up above if you want to know more. But when you have insulin resistance, this means that your insulin levels are high. And insulin is a hormone that, when it's elevated, it signals your body to store fat and not burn it. So basically, as long as your insulin is high, weight loss is gonna be difficult. And this is why you can be doing everything on paper right, but not getting the results you feel like you deserve. The key is bringing down your insulin levels, because when your insulin is lower, this is when your body is going to actually use your stored body fat for energy. Now, there are two things you're gonna wanna focus on to bring your insulin levels down. The first is reducing your body's need for insulin, because if your body doesn't have to produce as much insulin, then of course, your levels are gonna be lower. And the second thing you wanna focus on is improving your body's sensitivity to insulin. And this is basically how well the cells in your body take in insulin. Because when you're insulin resistant, the cells in your body are rejecting it, causing your circulating insulin to remain higher for longer than it should. Now, there are a few ways to do this: by reducing the amount of carbohydrates in your diet, you're reducing how much insulin your body actually needs, because carbohydrates are the macronutrient that requires the most insulin to process. Intermittent fasting can also help to improve insulin sensitivity and bring your insulin down. And low intensity exercise, like walking or swimming. And there are actually natural supplements like berberine that can help improve insulin sensitivity as well. Berberine is a compound that's found in several plants. And multiple studies have shown that it can lower blood sugar, improve insulin sensitivity, and even support fat loss. Studies have even shown that berberine performs just as well as the prescription drug metformin. Now, berberine doesn't work in the same way as these GLP-1 medications. It's more similar to metformin, which is also a very popular and very effective drug for weight loss. It works by activating AMPK, kind of like your body's cellular cleanup crew. And this helps improve how your cells use glucose. Berberine is affordable, well-researched, and available in supplement form. And unlike the patch, you know exactly what's in it. You can take it first thing in the morning or before meals that are high in carbohydrates. Now, the brand that I personally use and recommend is Balanced from So Well Health. And one of the main reasons I recommend it is because it's third-party tested. You know exactly what's in it, with the main ingredients being berberine, of course, and then chromium and cinnamon as well, which also help to control blood sugar, improve insulin sensitivity, and can help with weight loss too. I have a code for 10% off, that's Kait10, and I'll put the link in the description box down below if you wanna check it out for yourself. Now, to get real results, you have to make the diet and lifestyle changes though. Yes, berberine can be a tool and it can help to enhance your results, but you can't expect to just take it and not change anything you're doing in your life and for the weight to just come falling off. It works best when you use it with the correct diet and lifestyle changes, which we spoke about earlier. Okay, so now to wrap up, let's talk about how we can protect ourselves against falling for shady marketing like these GLP-1 patches. Here's a quick checklist I use for any new supplement or wellness trend. Number one, is it backed by peer-reviewed research? If there's no study linked, no PubMed results, and no experts backing it, that's a red flag. Number two, are the ingredients and doses listed clearly? If you can't tell what's in it, you can't trust it. And even better if it's third-party tested. And number three, is it making claims that sound too good to be true? Lose weight in 7 days or no effort required is your cue to run. So here's the bottom line. These GLP patches, yeah, they sound amazing, but there's nothing backing them up. GLP-1 is a powerful tool, but only when delivered properly, like through prescription medications. A patch just can't do that, or not yet at least. What you can do is focus on what works, a low-carb, high-protein diet, supplements like berberine, daily movement, good sleep, and blood sugar-friendly habits. There are no shortcuts, but there are tools, and there are smart strategies. You don't need to fall for gimmicks in order to see real results. Okay, so now I want to hear from you guys. Have you seen ads for these GLP-1 patches? Were you curious about trying them? Have you tried them? If you have, I really want to hear from you, so let me know in the comments down below. And I'm also going to link a video on the screen right now that is 5 subtle signs that your body is burning fat and not sugar for energy. So if you're feeling a little bit stuck and you're not sure why you're not losing weight, that video might have some more insights for you. But anyways, thank you guys for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Bye, guys.